Ladies and gentlemen, here they are. Please give a bit of warm welcome to the Riat Airport. Let's go to the team. The boss has called them into partnership. Displayed at many official and public ceremonies inside and outside the Kingdom of Saudi Arabia. This maneuver from the right, from Falcon, the boss is in the right here and will hand the right hand to Ben into spear again. Spear from the right for the left.
I don't think you practice in weather license very often in Saudi Arabia.
But all the more welcome given the circumstances. On the day when I think we thought the flying was going to be rather severely curtailed, it's great to get things underway with you guys.
We really get to see that, which is great, even though we have a bit of marginal weather today.
But this is, after all, very much an all-weather fighter, isn't it?
Yes, of course it is. So this is not a problem, but we have some regulations here in Riat, obviously, to follow. And here we see Andre during the low-speed pass. He gets down to roughly 100 knots above the runway. Soon you're about to see the upper part of the aircraft we're on
and do a full braking performance. However, today with these damp conditions, it will be slightly longer than we're used to. But still, rather impressive. Very, very impressive airplane. It's possible to see one of these different also close up in the second display here this weekend.
Yes, definitely. We came with two Griffinies. We have one for air display and we have one static. It's just next to our other song.
Hercules, please. And here it is in four of my past from the right. The Atlas C1. The 30th of June this year was a very sad day, saying goodbye to the C-130 as it did its tour around Britain after 56 years of service. I think most people... It also transports personnel. The mid-air refueling capability gives the RAF a real true global reach, as well as extending time in the air. The Voyager is also vital to NATO operations, very often refueling coalition aircraft on the
free plan. Tom Bold, Red One, leading in that initial trio.
For aircraft waiting for their display slot here, there is a hole directly over Bryce North, which is more or less where the C-135 is established now.
Yeah, which puts it exactly in the middle for routine operations of the Bryce North airspace. Most of the rear seats occupied at the moment with the guys this weekend to keep these aircraft serviceable, keep them in tip-top.
Other things about them, please keep a very tight hold on them, because anything that comes from the crowd line is likely to make its way to the runway, as we've seen the last three legs land. Occasional, with a 40% chance, between 1 o'clock and 7 o'clock, visibility of 3,000 metres with heavy rain. That is just a 40% probability. And then becoming half the show period, broken 800 with the cloud visibility improving as the evening comes on. But plenty of scope still to realise most of the revised flying programme that the display director is continuing to monitor. Thank you very much indeed, Mark. And it looks as though the
bubbles start coming up.
The boom and drone system was very, very unfamiliar. On most aircraft types, most tanker types, you have a hydraulic drum boom. And if the drone is pulling at about 300 pounds, the hydraulic drum boom actually pulls the drone towards the aircraft with the same force. So it's usually forgiven if you hit the drone hard. Thank you.
fly for a helicopter.
Hello,
placed in the same era as the UpBeat 2X6 standard in the cabin.
Yeah, so there were plans to develop the aircraft into a fighter-proof business jet, but that plan didn't gain any support. And the first of these arrivals is the tenth Red Arrow Hawk. So, a Belgian Air Components S16 fighting Falcon for graphics display. I think he's going to follow the Hawk in. Down the pond from the 50 Squadron, stationed at Florence. Okay.